2 weeks in Los Angeles, and you're working for Howard Hughes.
No harm having high hopes, ma'am.
And what church do you go to, Frank?
First Methodist in Fresno.
I forgive you.
She's kidding.
We're Baptist.
I've noticed over the years as I've been working on these kinds of films that every year that goes by, there are fewer and fewer and fewer places that you can film. The worst and most terrifying, of course, is driving a car down the street. The street lamps are incorrect. The line markings on the street are incorrect. Every house you drive by, if you want to drive past them and have the camera look past the characters and see a bit of the exterior, you have to bang on the doors and ask the people, can you please move your garbage cans? Can you move your furniture? Can we take down your plants? Can you move your car? Could you take your children's, you know, toys off the front porch? It's always the way it is. But the funny thing on Warren's film is he had been working with this researcher, Deborah Ricketts, who was very, very good, and she had her hands on all the stock footage houses in town. And she had been looking to see if, for some of that car footage, she could come up with stuff. She came up with this really wonderful piece of footage, I don't know where it's from originally, of a car driving down Hollywood Boulevard. And I looked at that and I thought, oh my God, those are the same Christmas trees on Hollywood Boulevard that I recreated for LA Confidential. That's correct. And we ended up using the footage and we ended up matching one of the cars from the footage for one of the main characters to be driving. That was the first. I'd never done that before. That was very interesting. And I had a big sigh of relief because, of course, you can't drive down Hollywood Boulevard anymore without, you can't even afford to fix it digitally. There's just too much.
I'm not some disgusting thief of a virgin trying to steal another woman's husband. Are you listening?
Need help?
Sometimes you get lucky because you find a neighborhood that's near a house that you're going to shoot that's pretty good. And sometimes you get lucky because you can only look and you can look in one direction. You don't need the other direction, so that's pretty good. It's really a process of just figuring it out, you know, driving around and figuring it out. You know, we all have in the back of our heads some ideas about what neighborhoods are still more or less intact. And of course, those poor people go crazy because the filmmakers are always setting on them like a pack of hungry dogs.
I heard Eisenhower sent him a telegram.
If Eisenhower was really smart, he'd have Howard Hughes just bomb Moscow and have communism over and done with.
I think Howard Hughes should be president.
We spent a lot of time looking at photographs of that period of life in Los Angeles. We spent a lot of time trying to find photographs of hotels of that era. It's also not something you find a lot of. And the rest of it was just really kind of refamiliarizing ourselves with Los Angeles and things that were pertinent to the script in the late 50s. That's really what it was. It's always the job of my department to set a high bar, a high standard, because we get there first. And I think that what happens is if you can set a high enough bar, everyone else who's coming behind you understands somehow physically or emotionally, intellectually, that the bar has been set high and you have to get over it. You have to reach it and you have to leap higher than even that bar has been set. And that's just something I've always been doing because I just have a sense that it's my job to make a proper nest for the actors and to feed them more so that they do a better job. Because honestly, the better job they do, the better off we all look. So that's just been my approach to things. Try to do it as wonderfully, as great as you can, so that you inspire, if possible, other people to do even better than they think they would have done.
Would you excuse me?
Shut the door.
I think one of the things that I thought about right away was, you know, Mr. Hughes lived his life in a series of hotel suites, basically, at this point, certainly. And I thought a lot about how to make each of these hotel suites easily distinguishable one from the other. Because you don't want the audience to get confused in terms of the environment. Where is this taking place now? So these hotel rooms can get very repetitive and very boring very quickly. So I knew that that was one of the big challenges. And just set about to try to figure out how to make one different from the other.
She still believes that once you've been intimate or gone all the way with a person, that in the eyes of God, you're committed to that person for the rest of your life.
I agree with Sarah. That's why I've never done it. That's why I'm waiting, because I have to be sure.
Caleb and I conspired almost every day to figure out how to get what we needed to make the film. And Albert and I talked almost every day as well, because of course we need to cross-pollinate. I need to tell him, okay, the London Hotel is coming up and you probably haven't gotten to thinking about the clothes yet, but I need to tell you that the basic color scheme is this or that, and as soon as I can send you some color chips or a wallpaper snippet, I'll do that. Because God forbid, you know, if the wallpaper is some kind of blue pattern, he has people showing up on the set in blue pattern, unless we want the characters to disappear into the wallpaper. So that's the nature of the collaboration.